Hey there, everyone. This is Ann Clemmer. There are a lot of things going on in this house. Yes, we are changing the craft room. Yeah, here at Central Bark. The dog made me do it. Yeah, you made me do it because it was getting out of control. So, hey, I'm going to talk about it today. Once again, this is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com. Let's get started. Stamper, come. Domino! Oh, we got a slow start today. We got Oregon in the house. We got North Carolina in the house. All is good. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's been crazy. Some of you who are in my dog pound, that's a special Facebook group we have for our clients, have seen some behind the scenes photos. Yeah, it can be scary. Oh, Deb, yes, you will see what we bought. You will see what we bought, but not today. Hold on. Come on. There we go. And there's so much stuff that we've taken off of the floor, so my husband can actually you smell it, don't you? He can actually walk in here and not trip on anything when he's trying to bring the dog in. Now, I'm going to tell you, I know to do this, but I can remember a long time ago, you know, Nancy was talking about, put up, a treat up by the camera so that he would look at it. Well, as you could tell, he's not sure where that treat is, but he does know it exists, don't you? Yeah, and he doesn't know what the T-R-E-A-T word means anyway, because we don't have a name for it. It's good boy, yeah. Oh, you could, yes. He loves it when I scratch his chest. That'll make him, but he's like going, where is that treat? I know I can smell it here. Yeah. Oh, but now he knows my husband's outside the door. Ah, okay. Right there. Good boy. Yes. What do you know? There you go. Oh, hand off. Oh my goodness. Yes, there's nothing on the floor down here. We went to IKEA. I got one of those Calyx things, but it's not, I don't want it to look like everybody else because I'm going to miss all these signs back here that you can only see when I step out of the picture, right? But look at all that stuff on the desk. That's got to go because I figured if I'm going to be moving stuff around, I better paint. And especially because, well, I will show you this. Because I think, yes. This, if I look to the left, maybe I showed you this before, I'm not sure, but if I look to the left, that's what I see. And I'm standing right to the right of that door handle right there. So yeah, and that's what's behind me because but see, I used to have some lac shelves there and one over here behind here. And I did get some shelves, but I thought the lac shelves, because they come straight out, there's nothing underneath them that they, you know, I'm afraid that they don't hold a lot. You know, like what do they hold? But anyway, yeah, you can see it is not wonderful, but you can see right where my 6-foot wall piece was. Yeah. So, you know, we're just trying to make it better for me and better for you. Yeah, that works out that way. So when I'm going to tell you how long it has been since I've done a really good scrape out here. Well, to give you an idea, hold on one second. Let me hit the right button here. That's the closest one. I found a pistachio pudding marker. Yeah, a pistachio pudding marker. And now you may know, I'm sure it's not something you memorize, but I found this card that Cindy gave me for my 19th anniversary with Stampin Up. Well, last February I did 24. So I mean, I'm at 24 and a half. Oh, that is a good question. No, not at this time. He does not walk freely in the room yet, but he will be able to once we get everything out of here. He could right now because but if there's ever any, like, let's say I drop this, and by the way, there's part of his treat. He would, golly, I think there was a card down here that he ate. No, I think I threw it away. There it is. Yeah. This was exposed. If he sees anything, right? This was a swap I got. And yes, he, I have showed you this before, but he, yeah, that's something I do tend to get dogs that, that like paper, you know, Stamper was the same way and Johnny Walker was the same way. So yeah, they all love paper. Maybe just, it's just dogs in general, but hey, since I see Nancy Clark is here, it's time for the T-shirt fashion show. And I figured I picked this one because it was appropriate to the time. And that is that we grow through what we go through. Yeah, so there. Yeah. Love it. Yes. Yeah, he probably would eat the embellishments. So anyway, I did find this card, and this is in the if you have kid cards you want to make, or you have people that like really whimsical cute stuff, this is on the clearance rack still, right? It's on the clearance rack still. And this is a card I got in a swap. I don't know when, because it's retired now, but it's still available, except for I don't think you can get this embossing folder. Is that it? They have to be a small dog. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah. and to give you another idea about cleaning this room, right? When they say in organizing, and this goes to my friend Karen Johnson, they told me a long time ago, and she helped me put some of this IKEA furniture in this room that is no longer available, but I love it. It's perfect for what, and sturdy for what I need. Anyway, she said, you know, when you clean your room, start with the drawers. And I mean, I have emptied so many drawers, and if you look at the last live stream, I showed you how many, that was just some of the drawers that I've emptied. And now every time I start a new drawer with some of those previously used drawers, right, I put a label on it, get everything in their place, you know, everything in their place. So what we're going to do today, because I have here's my plan, and I don't know about you, but where do you get your best ideas? Where do you get your best ideas? Because I tend to get them when I'm washing my hair. Yeah, when I'm in the shower, but mostly washing my hair. So it's a good thing I wash it every other day. Honestly, I have a hard enough time keeping track of which day to wash it. But anyway, there's something about massaging up here that really makes my brain go. And so I got my list of what order I need to put everything out today. Now, you know, I did talk about some things, but I do have to tell you that coming up is the end of the month. Yeah, it's a week from... Isn't it a week from yesterday, right? Is the end of the month. And since I can, I'm gonna move the garbage can. Sorry, I'm not facing you, but I'm gonna move the garbage can over here so I can throw some of these things away while I've got them. And I'm not talking about the cards I'm gonna show you. But bonus days are here. The refreshed clearance rack. Well, that's why I showed you that Yeti, because it's still in there for $25, you know, less than $25. You could get the dies and the stamp set. How cool is that? Yeah, I think that Marcy's got it right there. And I knew that's what it was. It was, yeah. And I've got a special thing that massages your head too. Yeah. So anyway, and beyond that, you're going to earn a $5 coupon to use next month for any... for every $50 that you purchase this month, right? So if you see something that you want now, look at, I mean, that Yeti bundle, that's, you're halfway there, right? But then next month, starting on the 1st, all the kits are on sale that are not paper pumpkin, right? So you can get 10, 20, or 30% off all during August. It will depend on what you, it will depend on what is available, right? Let me see if I can get, oh, look, and I can get in there. How about that? Okay, so let me tell you something that will help you shopping in general. And that is that if you see something in the online store, it's there, right? If it says unavailable now, that means it is coming back. So just keep watching because it's coming back. If it disappears, well, I'm sorry, it's gone for good, right? Or unless they decide to bring it back at a much later point, but that's probably not the way it's gonna go. That doesn't happen. See, look at, see? Patty agrees with me. Patty agrees with me. There. Yeah. So let's get on to this. Here. You may have seen some of these, and I'm going to get myself out of here so that I can go and go over here and turn my fan on. Oh, yeah. It's not, I don't think it's 90 yet. Anyway, these are, I hadn't thought about doing these together, but I'm thinking this is pecan pie. And moody mauve. I'm going to tell you one thing that's going to be really good about, a lot of these are done similar, but anyway, what's going to be nice is instead of turning around to get things in my, when I need it, it's going to be right over here to my left. Is that cool? Punch is going to be right there, and I'm going to have the, I'll be able to move the cut and emboss machine over there for a short while. I don't know. I may leave it all over there because that's where the paper is way at that end. So not that I have a big room, but it's big enough, right? Wow, how about this? It's so good. I put it upside down. Wishing you the brightest birthday. Only thing is, I think that might have been a better thing to stamp in Moody Moth. Great card, though. Great card. I caught these either on the ship or just before the ship. Okay, this is my friend Margaret. Yes, you're just too wonderful. Oh, very good. Yeah, that timeless greetings. Yeah. You're too wonderful. Yeah. And see, this is bubble bath, which is, I'm going to do something quickly today before we go. So yeah, stick around. You just don't know. This is my friend Jennifer from Texas coming up. I'm just throwing away what they came in. Isn't that nice? And the reason why I made sure I found this today was because my friend Janet, who lives up in Corning, about maybe an hour or so away from me, a little bit more. She had asked about, she saw that Oopsie-Daisy, and she goes, where in the catalog is that? And I'm going, oh, honey, I can find that for you. So where do you get your ideas from? I mean, you know, like, will a nice massage make that happen for you? If it does, you know, I mean, I'll be glad to test that theory. Yeah, I can't have the dog in here now. I just dropped a card. Yeah, he'll grow out of it because he's a baby. Okay, so this, I see. There you go. What a cute idea. Just swinging by just to say hi, and it's got a little swing there. So I'm going to use some colors today that I don't use a lot. Yeah. And then I'm going to challenge me and you. And you. Okay, let's see. Hold on. Wow, fancy fold. Okay, 10 fold here. And this opens like that. That's very interesting. It's too bad that this didn't have a, like a focal. It has him right there. That's one way to do it. Yeah, swaps are great because they, Okay, Pinterest. Okay, Pinterest. Yep. Dogs on Pinterest. Okay, hold on. Oh, here's if you want to conserve paper. You know, if you were going to give this to someone, see, this is a great idea for us, right? A great idea for us. It'd be nice if you put a little triangle. You know, the triangle. Which is this triangle, folks? Isosceles? Because that's the only one I remember. It's not a right angle, because this would be a right. This would be a right angle triangle, right? And is that a... Is isosceles the one that, okay, I'm asking for all you math wizards, the one that is equal on all sides, that could work too. But if you do something like this, then you go and then score it right here, right? And then just put that on the back. Now, I'm not talking about just about where do you get your ideas for stamping, but where do you get your ideas, period? I mean, have you tried to do anything new? I don't know if my husband had had Swedish meatballs before. I know he's had them because I've been to IKEA and bought them and brought them back, right? Not cooked, but, the bag. What's a wrong... What's a wrong triangle? Anyway, that would be good for this so that they could set it up afterwards. Because, you know, your mom, she likes to set things up. This one, yeah. Oh, look at they cut on the inside. Equilateral, thank you. Thank you. See, Susan's very smart. this one's a keeper. That's really nice. Wouldn't these be nice done in, like, silver? Or Knight of Navy so that they pop against this? I don't know. I'm happy with it the way it is. But right now, I can't really even just, make a card. But I'm going to make myself. It's so hard. No, it isn't. May the years ahead be filled with lasting joy. See, very simple, very pastel, very pretty. Yeah. If you see something that floats your boat, let me know. This is my friend Laura, who lives in the Midwest. By the way, I'm keeping these that have not been sealed or otherwise encumbered. Yeah. I always like Laura's stuff. It's on the tip, lemon lolly. Thank you. Yes, I was thinking that some of the, when Stampin' Up! Updated their systems today, that it was going to affect your shopping cart. No, it only affected the demonstrators, but we were all holding our breath for a little while because you know how computer upgrades can go. Yeah. Uh-huh. It's about time for me to upgrade this computer. I've had it 6 years, which is a long time for me. Oh, look at this. This is my friend in Hawaii. She always does Hawaiian-based things. I like this tone on tone. See, you don't even have to put a window sheet there. So this is a great mother-in-law card where you just put a little bit right there and you don't have to write a lot. Yes. Oh, Laura, great to see you. Haven't seen you in a while. Oh, yeah, which that reminds me, we've got our August Stampin' Play Day coming up. July was biggest prizes we'd ever had. Biggest prize was $90. Yeah, and you won't want to miss the next one. Yeah, you will not want to miss it. Okay, so here we go. That's a great idea. Isn't that a great idea? Instead of using these to pop those out, she popped them in. Yes, I'm sure. I'm sure my husband remembers this. See, we tuck so that people can reuse the envelopes. But some people don't. And this was my card, which I showed you a long time ago. So yeah, the people that I swapped with, we were all on the advisory board for Stampin Up at one point, not all at the same time. And so we still swap, even though Stampin Up doesn't do the advisory board anymore. This is cute. This is cute and easy, very easy. And this last one is, this is a color combination that I haven't done, but that's just what's in the paper. And I have a pack of that paper somewhere, right? And it's nice having a little bit of bling on there. But yeah, they're very muted colors and I'm getting used to them. So what I thought I would do is come out with an idea that I don't use a lot, but I know how to do it, and maybe you can help me through it, right? Or at least, you know, I'll be challenging you at the same time. Now, here, I know a lot of you get our magnets, but one of the things that I have in the same magnet area are these Teflon sheets. And these Teflon sheets are really a great thing to have because, like, I keep rather than have, you know, like padding, or I use, you know, using a pokey tool mat or whatever when I'm using photopolymer stamps like you should do. I have a full pad of grid paper that's underneath this black paper, right? See, it's a full pad, right? On the other side where I do most of my creating, that I just have the grid pad, but you know, you don't want to get it wet. So these Teflon sheets, you can get them wet, you can emboss on them, and I'm talking about heat emboss. You can do a lot of things. So oh my goodness, yes. Yes, I couldn't do math today. I could do it in my head. But so anyway, I've got a piece, and I believe it's 2.5 by 5 of watercolor paper. And I'm hoping that I have water in here. And I thought I would use a color combination of things that, well, I guess I'm using this. Oh, which is fine. And I'm gonna put colors on blocks. There's no water coming out yet. Let me encourage it. Let me encourage it. Come on. It hasn't been used in a while, and it's been standing. There it comes. There we go. I was looking for a spray, but none of them have anything in it. Hold on. If I wait for this to, okay, I'm going to get water on here. So you've probably seen it where you put water on the watercolor paper. And do you spritz the block too after you put ink on it? Hold on 1 second. Can you fill it up with water for me, please?
Yeah.
Thanks. So do I do both? You know, like this is something I know how to do and I could look it up if I wanted to, but I'm just going to go in, you know, what do you do? I'm just going to brush water on here. Hey, yeah. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Yes. That's our big prize winner. Yes, she got, yeah. $90. So with another $10, what'd she get? 2 bonus coupons so that she can use them next month. Okay, so these are the colors I picked. Bubble Bath, Azure Afternoon, Granny Apple Green. Yeah. Oh, I am so jealous. So which kind of equilateral triangle is this? Because that's like, yeah, I don't know which one is where it's equal all the way around. But what's the one? Is it isosceles where it's like it'd be two right angle triangles put together, something like that? I don't know. Yeah. Where the sum of two sides equal the other one. Why am I remembering these strange things? But yeah, so okay, let me go and get some blocks out. I'll get clean ones. Too big. Thank you, babe. This'll work. Thank you. So I'm going to put ink on here now. Okay, two equal sides. Thank you. Okay. See, it's the only Greek word I know. Our granddaughter is over in Greece right now, and she is loving it. You know, at least that's what her social media says. So when I put this in here, should I? Because I've already got water on this, and I think, you know, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. Because it's a mystery. Because what I want to encourage you to do is to make something between now and this weekend, or at least next Tuesday, that is using colors or a color combination you don't usually use. And or maybe a stamp set. You know, we all have stamp sets that we would. Nobody's telling me this. Wow, look at that. That looks a little rough. I didn't get enough out here, so I'm gonna do it twice. I think I'm gonna give it a spritz. I'll spritz it over here. Right over by the electronics, right? He just put water in it. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna stamp here. Boy, this is awfully light. Ooh, very, very, yeah, okay. Now, how about this? I do not have to use a... stamp cleaner because I've got paper towels. But maybe I want to do it again. So this time, okay, I cleaned it off. Let's see what it does without it. See, when you spritz it, it does it better. Now, what I can do, because, you know, the perfectionist in me, I can go and take this and try to smush them a little bit together. Maybe I'm defeating the purpose. This is something I know how to do, but don't. I'm sure you got something that you know how to do and you don't. Maybe it's foiling. Okay, now this I am going to clean it in between just in case I use it again. Oh my, the things we don't know about Patty. Well, how about this? I took 6 years of Spanish. That doesn't do anything for me. Okay, so I'm cleaning that off because you don't, you know, I'm funny about mixing up my colors. And, okay. Nope, I wasn't going to do this. I wasn't going to do, clean it off again. See, look it. This is juicy. Now I could just turn around and, but I, you know, and spray. Whoa, look at that. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Miss Ann doesn't like messy stuff. Woo! Oh, see, I shouldn't have added that extra because see how it's just moving where I didn't want it to move. But I can go and move it this way. Ooh, yeah, that's right about where I want it, right there. That's good enough. In a perfect world, I would still have my my heat tool put here. That's awful intense. I didn't think that was going to be that intense. Hello. Oh, that just... Oh, I like texts like that. Oh, do I? It is. Oh, it is plugged in, I think. And what's nice about our heat tool is that it has a drying. Now, if I don't use this, I will redo it again with the same colors, or at least the same layout. Okay. Now I'm glad I didn't use blueberry bushel. Because Azure afternoon was pretty intense for me. Oh, look at it, except for now it's kind of, let's make sure this is, I want it to be wet down here. And I dried it, you know, a bit. Okay, it's better now. I'm sure I could do better than this. I don't mind messing up with you. Okay. However, I will want to get that off of my hands before I do my appointment. Okay. This time I'm only going to spritz it once. Oh, maybe twice. Okay. And I'm going to put that here. Whoa. And it's probably a good idea to squish, you know. Whoa. That's pretty intense too. Clean it off. Yes, this is watercolor paper. So I can put a lot of water on it. 2.5 by 5. Now when it dries, I believe it's going to be slightly... It's going to be slightly lighter. Okay, how can I do like a partial here? I'm going over this way so I don't get too much on my... Masterpiece. Okay, so there's your challenge. Use colors that you don't normally use, or a layout you don't normally use, or a... Whoa. Yeah, that might need a little bit of coaxing. I put 2 on this, or 1.5, and I put 1 on that. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to go and give it a little bit of... Fill it in a little bit. You won't tell, will you? There. See, just need a little bit of help. Then I'm just going to let this air dry, because I have some spackling to do and some, you know, if I want to have this has to be to where most of the stuff is back in the room, you know, by Thursday night, because the cleaning agent will be here Friday and we don't want to stress her out. And if you have it, okay. Now I told you, I emptied several drawers, right? Yeah, and do you know, even though I emptied several drawers, we have things in the hallway, in the office, in our bedroom, in the front room, in the dining room area, everywhere except for the kitchen and the bathrooms. And those could be used too. So I'm going to leave you with something that my husband wrote on a piece of paper one time. Yeah, like this, and put it on my desk when I first started thinking about cleaning up, which was a long time ago. He said, stop thinking about how far you have to go. Instead, start celebrating how far you've come. I'm going to leave you with that. And go try something new. Make a card, put it in the mail. It's only 63 cents to bless someone's day. This is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun.
Yeah, baby.
Into your day. Hey, and go see that Barbie movie. Have a good laugh. Bye.